Behold, the day of the Lord cometh, cruel, both with wrath and fierce anger, to lay the land desolate, and he shall destroy the sinners thereof out of it. For the stars of heaven and the constellations thereof shall not give their light. The sun shall be darkened in his going forth, and the moon shall not cause her light to shine. And I will punish the world for their evil, and the wicked for their iniquity. And I will cause the arrogancy of the proud to cease, and will lay low the haughtiness of the terrible.
Many ministries in the awakening as well as in the beast system spend a lot of time teaching the people about the seen things. People can relate to the things they can see. When it comes to the unseen, many people find it difficult to understand. The word of the Most High in the scripture said, "Do not look at the things that are seen, but the unseen. For the things that are seen are temporary, and the things that are not seen are eternal."
For we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen are eternal.
There are many people who read 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 18, and wonder what the meaning is. Throughout the scriptures, the Most High revealed that he wants his people to serve him in spirit and in truth. The things that are seen are flesh or carnal, and the things that are unseen are spirit and eternal. The reason many understand flesh, they spend their entire life operating in the flesh. Because they operate in the flesh, they do not understand spirit. The book of Corinthians in the Bible said, "Although we walk in the flesh, we do not war after flesh."
But I beseech you that I may not be bold when I am present with that confidence wherewith I think to be bold against some which think of us as if we walked according to the flesh. For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh.
There is a difference between walking in the flesh and operating in the flesh. To live in the physical realm, we must have a body. Without an earthly body, we cannot live in the physical realm. Our human body is called flesh. Everyone that passed away can no longer live or operate in the physical realm because their spirit has separated from their earthly body. The result of your spirit separating from your body is called death.
For as the body without the spirit is dead, so faith without works is dead also.
When the scripture said, "Although we walk in the flesh," this is saying we have flesh to live here, but we do not operate in the flesh. When our spirit obtained a human suit in the womb and the woman complete the various stages of pregnancy, our mothers give birth. The reason we cannot see unclean spirits, they are disembodied spirits. Unclean spirits attach themselves to a person to control that person. The man in the tomb is a great example of a person being controlled by unclean spirits. Although we could not see the multitude of spirits operating in the man, the presence of unclean spirits was evident through the man's behavior.
And always, night and day, he was in the mountains and in the tombs, crying and cutting himself with stones.
The workers of iniquity in the beast system would diagnose the man in the tomb with a mental illness. The workers of iniquity would prescribe the man in the tomb prescription drugs to treat his symptoms. Remember, Israelites, prescription drugs are only treating symptoms. They do not cure illnesses of any sort. That is why they are temporary relief. Just like the scripture said, the seen things are temporary. 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 3 said, "Although we live in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh." Yes, we are humans. However, the root to our problems come from the unseen things. To properly solve our problems, we must look at the unseen and attack the unseen things through spiritual warfare. The root to the problem with the men in the tombs were evil spirits. The people in his generation believed binding him with chains would solve his problems. Chaining him down did not solve the man in the tomb's problems.
Who had his dwelling among the tombs, and no man could bind him, no, not with chains, because that he had been often bound with fetters and chains, and the chains had been plucked asunder by him, and the fetters broken in pieces, neither could any man tame him.
As you heard, binding him with chains did not solve his problems. The evil spirits continued to torment him day and night. Casting out the evil spirits would solve his problems. That was the first thing Yeshua did to help the man suffering from legions of evil spirits from tormenting him.
But when he saw Jesus afar off, he ran and worshipped him, and cried with a loud voice and said, "What have I to do with thee, Jesus, thou Son of the Most High God? I adjure thee by God that thou torment me not." For he said unto him, "Come out of the man, thou unclean spirit."
The beast system has separated the people from the Most High that many do not know. The Most High gave them the ability to cast out evil spirits. Casting out devils is a foreign language to the people of the Most High. Israelites, the root to all your problems are evil spirits. You must know spiritual warfare. You cannot cure a person suffering from demon possession with prescription drugs. The person needs deliverance. When you are dealing with illnesses of any sorts, you must attack the spirit of infirmity. That is the root cause to any sickness. The beast system disguised the spirit of infirmity with many names. Diabetes, COVID, high blood pressure, and cancer are some of the names.
Behold, there was a woman which had a spirit of infirmity 18 years, and was bowed together, and could in no wise lift up herself. And when Jesus saw her, he called her to him and said unto her, "Woman, thou art loosed from thine infirmity."
The scriptures you just heard said the woman who suffered for 18 years had a spirit of infirmity that prevented her from walking properly. The scriptures revealed the woman's condition was due to an evil spirit. Although the woman could not see the spirit of infirmity, the evil spirit was present in her life tormenting her. Israelites, it is important to focus on the unseen. The next time the doctors say you have high blood pressure or any other disease, rebuke the spirit of infirmity that is plaguing your body in the form of high blood pressure or the other ways it manifests itself in your life. We must have a mindset that will lead us to cast out devils instead of treating symptoms. By the way, your family medical history revealed generational curses in the form of infirmity. You need to know this to properly treat your conditions. Protesting is not preventing evil spirits from tormenting you. That is why we do not wrestle with flesh and blood. The scriptures made it clear that our warfare is not carnal.
For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds.
We would have to look to the unseen to find the root to our problems. The unseen things are eternal. Spirits do not die. The book of Matthew revealed to us that when an unclean spirit is cast out of a person, it stays in dry places being tormented. If the evil spirit can't find another person, it will return to the person it was cast out of. The scripture said the condition of that person is worse than before.
When the unclean spirit is gone out of a man, he walketh through dry places seeking rest, and findeth none. Then he saith, "I will return into my house from whence I came out." And when he is come, he findeth it empty, swept, and garnished. Then goeth he, and taketh with himself seven other spirits more wicked than himself. And they enter in and dwell there. And the last state of that man is worse than the first. Even so shall it be also unto this wicked generation.
Have you noticed the downward spiral of a person who relapsed from alcohol and drug abuse? They go from clean to an addict in a matter of seconds. The reason their conditions are worse, when the evil spirit that was cast out return, it brings other devils more wicked to take over the person. Instead of one spirit, the person is now occupied by many devils, just like the man in the tomb. When Yeshua asked the evil spirit his name, he said legion, because they were many.
And he asked him, what is thy name? And he answered, saying, my name is legion, for we are many.
If you do not eliminate the root to a problem, the individual could suffer a physical death or declare disabled and can no longer care for themselves. What the beast system labeled mental illness is actually a person that is controlled by evil spirits, like the man in the tomb. When a person is controlled by unclean spirits, he or she has suffered a spiritual death. Israelites, the reason it is important for you to focus on the unseen, we are living in a time where the people of the Most High must understand the language of the Most High. We can no longer interpret what is happening in the world by what we see only. We must go behind the scenes to see what is happening at the root. The root to everything lies in the spirit realm. I hope the people of the Most High can finally comprehend why the Most High want his people to worship in spirit and in truth.
But the hour cometh, and now is, when the true worshippers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeketh such to worship him. God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth.
The dwelling of the Most High is in the spirit realm. The Most High do not have a human body like us. He is invisible. Although he is invisible, Yah is everywhere. Israelites, you do not need a human body to operate in the spirit realm. That is why when you are sleeping, your body remains here in the physical realm and your spirit travels to the spirit realm. It is important to understand whatever is going to happen in this world and your life will take place in the spirit realm first, then manifest into the physical realm. Most of the stories we read in the scriptures were taking place in the spirit realm. There are many people who do not know most of the scriptures are visions given to the prophets of the Most High in the spirit realm. Yes, the prophets were sleeping when the Most High spoke to them. Most covenants are established in the spirit realm.
And God spake unto Israel in the visions of the night and said, Jacob, Jacob. And he said, here am I. And he said, I am God, the God of thy father. Fear not to go down into Egypt, for I will there make of thee a great nation.
When the Most High said to Jacob, I will make you a great nation, the Most High established a covenant with Jacob. Covenants are important when dealing with the things of the spirit. A good example is the Most High making a covenant with Abraham. There were no written contracts declaring the Most High would give Abraham the land of Canaan for a possession. The agreement was a spiritual covenant between the Most High and Abraham. Later, the Most High transferred the covenant to Isaac, Jacob, and Jacob's descendants, the Israelites. The scriptures reveal to us that the Most High speak to his people through their dreams.
God speaketh once, yea, twice, yet man perceiveth it not. In a dream, in a vision of the night, when deep sleep falleth upon men, in slumberings upon the bed, then he openeth the ears of men, and sealeth their instruction.
The Most High said in the book of Job, when he speaks to his people, they do not notice. The beast system did a phenomenal job of hiding the things of the spirit from the people. The Zionist church do not teach the people about the spirit realm. Their focus is mostly on the Messiah that came in his own name. The high-level workers of iniquity and religion are not going to show you how to break free from their evil altars. Their goal is to keep you in bondage. The church is filled with high-level workers of iniquity. Israelites, do not neglect what you see in the spirit realm. Your dreams are of high importance. Depending on how you respond would determine what kind of life you would live in the physical realm. The scripture said, in the last days, the Most High will pour out his spirit on his people, causing them to have visions, dream dreams, and prophesy.
And it shall come to pass, in the last days, saith God, I will pour out of my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. And on my servants and on my handmaidens I will pour out in those days of my spirit, and they shall prophesy.
We are the generation that is living in the times of sorrows. This generation must understand how to decode the visions and dreams they shall receive from the Most High concerning their life and the people around them. Israelites, keep in mind that some of your dreams are not about your life. Sometimes the Most High show you what is happening in the lives of the people around you. The scriptures reveal how the Most High spoke to Nathan, the prophet, to say to King David, should he build the Most High a house in a dream.
And it came to pass that night that the word of the Lord came unto Nathan, saying, Go and tell my servant David, Thus saith the Lord, Shalt thou build me an house for me to dwell in?
Nathan had to trust the Most High to believe what he saw in the realm of the Spirit to share with King David. Faith is the conviction of things that are not seen. To serve the Most High in the Spirit, you're going to have to trust the Most High, especially when Yah is pouring out His Spirit on His people and their dream life activity increase. You can't rely on someone else to tell you the meaning to what you saw. Abraham believed the Most High when Yah said He would make him a great nation. Abraham had faith in the Most High even though his physical condition did not support the promise the Most High made to him. How could he be a great nation without children? Sarah did not bear Isaac until she was 90 years old. You must have faith to serve the Most High in the Spirit.
Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen.
For those who do not know, the spirit realm is your dream life. When I say dream, I'm not referring to your inspirations. I am talking about the visions and the things you see when you are sleeping. Your visions and dreams are inspired by the Most High or the kingdom of darkness. Remember, Satan imitates everything the Most High does. If the Most High speaks to you in the spirit realm, the kingdom of darkness will speak to you in the spirit realm as well. The scriptures warn us to cast down every imagination and thoughts that are contrary to the words of the Most High.
Casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ.
The Most High said in the last days He would pour out His Spirit on His people. His people would prophesy, see visions, and dream dreams. The scriptures must be fulfilled. Because we are living in the times of sorrows, the people of the Most High need to understand the visions and dreams they will have. You must understand how the Most High communicate with His people in the spirit realm, as well as in the physical realm. Let us discuss how the Most High communicate with you in the spirit. The Most High use symbols to communicate with His people in the spirit realm. Every object that you see are symbols. Even the elements and the constellation are symbols in the spirit realm. Joseph had a dream where he saw the sun, the moon, and 11 stars bowing down to him.
And he dreamed yet another dream, and told it his brethren, and said, Behold, I have dreamed a dream more, and behold, the sun, and the moon, and the 11 stars made obeisance to me.
According to the scriptures, the sun and the moon represent his mother and father. The 11 stars represented his brothers. The Most High gave Jacob the interpretation of the dream to reveal to Joseph the meaning.
And he told it to his father and to his brethren. And his father rebuked him and said unto him, What is this dream that thou hast dreamed? Shall I and thy mother and thy brethren indeed come to bow down ourselves to thee to the earth?
Israelites, remember, majority of your dreams are not direct. The sun, the moon, and the stars are not going to bow down to Joseph. The Most High did not create the sun, the moon, and stars to bow down. The objects in your dreams do not symbolize the same things in the physical realm. If you see yourself buying a house in the spirit realm, the dream is not revealing you are buying a house. You would have to decode the symbols. In this example, the house and the amount of money you spent are symbols, as well as the weather conditions to what you are wearing, the colors of your clothing, and the people that is with you or standing around. When decoding the symbols, you can't leave anything out. That is why you are in a better position to decode the symbols in your dreams, because you are the one seeing them. Keep in mind, Israelites, nobody can decode your visions and dreams unless the Most High give them the understanding. Both Joseph and Daniel had to ask the Most High for the interpretation of a dream before they could reveal the meaning.
And they said unto him, We have dreamed a dream, and there is no interpreter of it. And Joseph said unto them, Do not interpretations belong to God? Tell me them, I pray you. And Daniel went to his house, and made the thing known to Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah, his companions, that they would desire mercies of the God of heaven concerning the secret, that Daniel and his fellows should not perish with the rest of the wise men of Babylon. Then was the secret revealed unto Daniel in a night vision. Then Daniel blessed the God of heaven.
Sometimes the Most High will use someone to give you the interpretation to your visions and dreams. The person must be a servant of the Most High. That is important. In Daniel's case, when it came to prophecy about the future, the Most High sent Gabriel to reveal to Daniel the interpretation of his visions.
And it came to pass, when I, even I, Daniel, had seen the vision and sought for the meaning, then, behold, there stood before me as the appearance of a man. And I heard a man's voice between the banks of Ulai, which called and said, Gabriel, make this man to understand the vision.
Israelites, seek the Most High for the interpretation of the visions and dreams you see in the spirit realm. Do not believe everyone who tell you they can give you the interpretation to your visions and dreams. The workers of iniquity use divination and familiar spirits to interpret your dreams. The scriptures gave us a good example of a worker of iniquity using witchcraft powers to summon a familiar spirit pretending to be Samuel to speak to King Saul when the Most High stopped all forms of communication with King Saul.
And when Saul inquired of the Lord answered him not, neither by dreams, nor by Urim, nor by prophets. Then said Saul unto his servants, Seek me a woman that hath a familiar spirit, that I may go to her, and inquire of her. And his servant said to him, Behold, there is a woman that hath a familiar spirit at Endor.
The workers of iniquity want to know about your visions and dreams to steal from you and to place a stronghold on your life. Remember I said to you, Satan speak to you in the spirit realm. The kingdom of darkness will come to steal from you and forge covenants with you in the spirit realm. The scripture said, while men slept, the enemy came and sowed tares and went his way. Please protect your dream life.
But while men slept, his enemy came and sowed tares among the wheat and went his way.
There are many things to consider when decoding the symbols in your visions and dreams. The spirit realm is governed by the laws of the Most High. There is no escaping the laws of the Most High. Any vision or dream that is leading you to break the laws of the Most High comes from the kingdom of darkness. Israelites, it is important to use discernment. You must differentiate dreams and visions that comes from the kingdom of darkness and from the Most High. The dreams from Satan are deceptive and contrary to the things of the Spirit.
That which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit.
When decoding the symbols, use the words of the Most High to find the hidden meaning behind the objects in the vision or dream. The chief baker in Pharaoh's house had a dream and he seeked Joseph for the interpretation. He saw three white baskets on his head and in the last basket, there were all kinds of baked goods. The baker saw birds eating the baked meats that was in the basket on top of his head.
When the chief baker saw that the interpretation was good, he said unto Joseph, I also was in my dream, and behold, I had three white baskets on my head, and in the uppermost basket there was of all manner of baked meats for Pharaoh, and the birds did eat them out of the basket upon my head.
Joseph interpreted the dream for the chief baker in Pharaoh's house. The interpretation revealed that the baker was going to die.
And Joseph answered and said, This is the interpretation thereof. The three baskets are 3 days. Yet within 3 days shall Pharaoh lift up thy head from off thee, and shall hang thee on a tree, and the birds shall eat thy flesh from off thee.
Israelites, did you notice the Most High did not use a funeral to tell the baker his fate? If you use the language of the physical realm, you would not associate death with the baker's dream. Nowhere in his dream did you see the baker being hanged and his family crying and holding a funeral service. When the Most High communicate with his people in the spirit realm, he used symbols. The Most High do not speak to us in the language we use in the physical realm. The Most High does nothing according to the flesh. The Most High used symbols that revealed the baker's fate. Birds in the scriptures are called fowls of the air, and they are often portrayed as eating the flesh of dead carcasses.
For wheresoever the carcass is, there will the eagles be gathered together. And thy carcass shall be meat unto all fowls of the air and unto the beasts of the earth, and no man shall fray them away.
The three white baskets determine the date of his execution. The fact that he was carrying the basket on his head further symbolized his death. The baked goods in the basket symbolized his occupation. He was the chief baker in Pharaoh's house. The bread in the basket identified who would execute him. The fact that the birds was eating the bread he was carrying in a basket on his head showed that the birds was eating his carcass. Remember, birds are associated with death in the scriptures. Can you see the symbolism? As we approach the end times, many prophecies will unfold. As the Most High reveal what is coming to his people in a dream, we must do our part in understanding the Most High. The Most High prophesied the end from the beginning to help his people. When the wrath of the Most High is on the nations, the remnant will have knowledge if they pay attention to their dreams and visions. Remember, everything that is going to take place will happen in the spirit realm first, then manifest in the physical. The unseen things play a major role in our lives. That is why the word of the Most High tells us to focus on the unseen. The baker's situation, the unseen things behind the scenes, revealed the spirit of death was at his door. When you begin to see visions and dream dreams, make sure to write them down and only share if the Most High instruct you to reveal what he has shown you. The scriptures must be fulfilled. Do not rely on the beast system to tell you the truth. The awakening is happening for the people of the Most High to take charge of their life. Israelites, it's time that you become independent from the beast system to become dependent on the Most High.
He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in Him will I trust. Surely, He shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler.